just now turning after 10 a.m. on Thursday, April the 19th here in Moscow. Welcome to the program on RT International. Here come your top headlines. A Russian correspondent from Russia 24 TV is claiming to have found a Syrian boy seen in footage said to show the aftermath of an alleged chemical attack. In an interview which cannot be independently verified, the child and his father recall how events unfolded in Duma on April the 7th.
These are harrowing scenes. Panic, fear, terror. Soaked, trembling children, screaming adults, and strange as it may seem, many of them had no idea about what was going on.
We were in the basement. My mother told me that we had run out of food and wouldn't have anything to eat until tomorrow. I heard a noise outside. Somebody was shouting that we had to go to the hospital, so we went there. When I came in, some people grabbed me, started pouring water over my head.
11-year-old Hassan Diab was one of the apparent victims in the White Helmets video. Here he is after being drenched and sprayed. He was found in Duma and interviewed by Russian war correspondent Yevgeny Podubny. He's fine, if a little confused.
That's me in the video, that's me. Yes.
As were many other kids. Any child would be terrified, ergo the panic which the White Helmets were there to film. He was eventually found, though, by his father, who was none the wiser.
I didn't hear anything about a chemical attack. I was outside, but I didn't notice anything. I heard that my family was in the hospital.
It does make sense. A poisonous gas would be invisible, you'd imagine. Everybody would want to take precautions, especially when you're hungry and they give out food at the hospital.
I went to the hospital, walked upstairs and found my wife and children. I asked them what had happened, and they said people outside were shouting about some smell and told them to go to the hospital. At the hospital, they gave dates and cookies to the kids.
One of the doctors, who was reportedly on shift at the time, seemed surprised by the sudden influx.
Some people come to here and wash people in water, and they said, chemical attack. We didn't see any chemical attack symptoms here.
The doctor and others did, however, say that some people came in complaining about difficulty breathing, which is common. When an explosion destroys a building, for example, there's a lot of dust, makes it difficult to breathe, and especially affects people with asthma.
People from the White Helmets told us about the use of chemical weapons, but we saw no sign of that. If chemical weapons were used against those people, our medical staff would have also been affected.
We've sent a request to the White Helmets to comment on this, but have received no answer yet. What we have seen is more and more witnesses coming forward to say there was only panic and no evidence of chemicals.
We heard an explosion and somebody said it was a chemical weapon. We ran to where the noise came from and started pouring water over the people. But they seemed to be okay and then walked away without any help.
People got so confused. Somebody started pouring water over people's heads, saying there had been a chemical attack. I was at the spot with my wife and daughter, but none of us experienced any symptoms of chemical poisoning.
It's remarkable how these scenes convinced three countries to launch cruise missiles at Syria. Especially remarkable when you realize that so many of the people here had no idea about what was going on, only that someone shouted about chemicals.
The U.S. and the majority of European countries say a chemical attack did happen in the town of Duma, citing their own intelligence sources. They accused the Syrian government of deploying a toxic agent over the area, which at the time was held by militants. American, British and French militaries hit Syria with an airstrike in retaliation, targeting a number of facilities which they claimed were related to chemical weapons production and development. Meanwhile, allegations of a chemical attack are now being questioned even by some in the Western media. British journalist Robert Fisk visited Douma and wasn't able to find any witnesses. Former counter-terrorism officer Charles Shoebridge says he's also seeing signs of backtracking on the accusations.
Journalists have got in on the ground. Robert Fisk is a notable person that I'm thinking of there. He, as he says, unattended by Syrian government employees and so on, he spoke to ordinary residents and to medical staff, who, none of whom confirmed the idea that there was a chemical attack. We're already, I think, seeing, I'm detecting signs myself, that there is a slight backtracking amongst government statements, rowing back slightly, saying, well, actually, we weren't completely clear. That's why we were relying on social media, we were relying on activists on the ground, and that's why we only carried out a limited strike. So they're already, I think, preparing the ground for the possibility, at least, that this OPCW report isn't particularly helpful. For example, it may actually find that there were no trace of chemicals, of chemical warfare.
A team from the chemical weapons watchdog, the OPCW, came under fire in Syria on Wednesday while trying to enter the town of Douma.